the patient came back, in this case, the patient came back after delivery for a recall, and he's complaining from pain. In this video, I'm concentrating on how to check for types of pain. I'm going to remove the lower. I'm going to remove the upper. And I'm going to begin from the upper first. Now, there are types of checks that we need to make. So I'm going to use my finger. I'm going to walk around different areas to differentiate the types of pain. First of all, I'm going to walk with my finger inside the sulcus without touching the ridge. Okay, I should not touch the ridge in this case. I'm walking from an area with no pain. في أي وجه هون؟ خفيف. خفيف. I'm inside the sulcus. My finger is not touching the ridge. هون في أي وجه؟ I'm walking. I'm mapping the area. ففي شوي هون إشي خفيف قلت لي. هون إشي خفيف. It's in the side the sulcus around the distal buccal angle. هون في أي وجه هون؟ I'm avoiding the ridge. أي وجه هون؟ I concentrate around the frenum because this is a frequent area. أي وجه هون؟ هون. هون. هون بالأكل. Corner. It's on the distobuccal as well on the other side. Why am I using my finger by this mapping method? Because patients, when they are elderly, they lose what we call cognitive ability. Or sometimes they lose motor, or they lose some motor function movements. So suppose he has some pain in the area. Look how specific we are. Distobuccal angle, using my finger. But when the patient complains, he's complaining from pain here. Where is here? Sometimes they point to the upper alone. Sometimes they don't know. They cannot differentiate this from the upper from the lower, depending either on the cognitive mental abilities or because of their motor ability. They cannot finally put their hand on the area where it has pain. So this is the sense of having this mapping method. So once more, I'm in the sulcus, mapping, going around, avoiding the crest, the ridge itself, because I'm concentrating on the border. Now this is not enough. I have to go back and do another map on another line of mapping, which is over the slopes of the ridge, because this is a different area from the sulcus. Sulcus is border flange areas, okay, that might be overextended. But on the slope of the ridge, we're looking at the undercut engagement. We're looking at the fitting surface of the denture in areas of undercut, especially when we have natural undercuts. في عندك أي وجه هون؟
أي.
خفيف. Over this undercut. في أي وجه هون؟
لا.
So I'm wiping on the slopes of the ridge. Okay, وجحون. There are natural undercuts, but they don't have any pain. So I am engaging them correctly. هون في شوي. خليني أنا حطه بسوي. So he's complaining. في هاي وجحون.
لا هي شوية.
هون. So it's over here. Okay. So this is on the slope of the ridge. هون في أي وجه؟
لا.
طيب هون. في أي وجه؟
خليه بقية.
وين هون؟ So he complained. I'm feeling that he's complaining more from the undercut engagement rather than from the border. It's more on the fitting surface. The third map we do is over the crest of the ridge. في هلا في أي وجه أنا ماشي هيك؟ I'm compressing because over the crest of the ridge I could detect pressure points on the if we have a knife edge ridge. Or sometimes if we have nerve compression. So I want you to look closely when I come close to the incis of papilla. Okay, I'm killing bumps. في وجه هون؟ هون ما في. بس هون على اللفة؟ طب هون؟ ما في. So it's not nerve compression that he's complaining from. He's complaining from undercut engagement. Okay? He has a bony prominence here. And this is an area of undercut. طب هون ماشية؟ طب خليني هاي على جنب شفتها انا بدي هلا هاي انه اركز هون في وجه
لا
ممتاز في اي شيء ممتاز so see this mapping في اي وجه هون so if I have pain in the crest area usually it comes from a knife edge ridge or a nerve compression if it's the upper or nerve compression in the mental area if it was the lower or from sometimes if I have heavy occlusion it will detect heavy occlusion areas. لسه هاي ما شفناها. بحنا خلينا في الفؤاد. So these are the three types of mapping I wanted to see. These types of mapping we only use them in the recall visit. We don't use them in the first visit. In the first visit we depend on the pressure indicating paste and the other checks we have talked about. But in the recall visit I need to identify where is the area of the pain. So the sum for this patient is border, slight border pain here. هون ما في وجع.
ايش
حبيبي؟ So it's not the undercut, it's the border. بينما هون on this side هون في وجع وهون في اكو وجع. Look at the reaction of the patient. So it's more undercut engagement. So is this enough? No. I need to take. So am I going to bring the bear and begin trimming? No. I have to put pressure indicated first, but looking specifically at those areas. So I'm going to I'm going to place my pressure indicating face in this area, and on the sides a little bit. I'm in here because this is an undercut. I'm going to put on the fitting surface as well. The surface should be dry when I'm applying the pressure indicating face, and then I'm going to do all the functional movements in this stage. In the fitting surface, there are no functional impressions. Sorry. In the fitting surface, there are no functional movements to do. Actually, the functional movements are only working on the borders. Okay? So I'm going to place my pressure indicating face thinly over this area. This is the corner he was complaining from. So it's a border problem. Here, it's the fitting surface problem. Should be done. Here I'm going to place it over the undercut area. And make sure that my layer of the pressure indicating face is thin over the border on the sides. On the side. Make sure I'm not leaving any areas empty. I'm coming in lightly. The tissue is not moving it away. Sorry. This is another sign of undercut pain. Usually the pain is on insertion and removal, not actually on during good movements. Okay, the cheek movement, by the way, doesn't reach the corner we're looking for. So I'm just doing the cheek movements just. Okay, افتح الآخر. This is what works in the corner area. افتح الآخر. سكر. يمين شمال. أيوة بدي أشد عليه شوي. It's good to have pressure in place. And I'm going to remove it now, slowly, and look at the body. Okay, so there is the pain coming from. Here, the corner is wiped away, correct, so we need to remove it using the bear. Here, look at this undercut. Okay. This is a good example of undercuts, how they work. Opposite undercuts are favorable if they are less than 180 degrees. Anything beyond the 180 degrees is interfering with the insertion and removal. So in this direction, I should not have any undercut engagement. So the undercut engagements to have this go in and utilize without traumatizing the patient should not exceed 180 degrees. So if I draw a straight line, this undercut is beyond this 180 degrees. And this is why it's painful to the patient. Because this undercut is interfering with this undercut. This undercut, I cannot take it away. So this is excessive engagement. So we need an undercut engagement that is enough to put in and utilize without traumatizing the patient. So this is the undercut where he's complaining from. There's a very slight area of wiping away. I could have seen it while I was placing the pressure indicator press that this is a sharp line angle. I'm just going to smooth it out. But this is actually the undercut that has the pain. Any border, slightly roundation of this border, slight roundation of this border is thick. Here, no, the length of it, and it's also sharp. So I'm going to use my bear. So I'm going to use the bear to trim it away. So on the border. So on the border, I only have this point slightly. Thickness. I have this. I'm not going to remove it. I'm going to remove this undercut engagement. It could be undercut engagement and it could be over carving at the post down in this area. And the area that I told you was sharp, there is a line on there. And this one, I'm going to round it out from the corner. I'm rounding out the angles. This is the sharp angle. Done my corrections correctly, what the patient will feel is an immediate relief, but not a total relief, because the old pain is still there. He has come with pain and ulceration after he had used this denture. So this immediate relief, he will feel a difference, but not the total relief. Okay, so I'm going to put it in place. حاسس انه اريح هلا في اللي فوق في اي وجع كثير ضايل طبعا الوجع القديم لساته موجود بقايا الوجع القديم بس التجريح والضرب اللي كان يضربه محل الوجع في راحه خلص اعمل الحركات اللي كانت توجعك في اي وجع فيها لسه ولا خلص خلصنا ولا في لسه ضايل شوي طيب I'm going to repeat. Same areas, here is undercut. Entering in, the tissue doesn't move the border. Okay, افتح A, يمين شمال. And I take it out. While I was entering, the tissue moved this, so I'm not going to consolidate it on this area unless I am doing it alone. Okay, so this is where I seated the denture purely. See how the amount of reduction, amount of wiping away is less than last time. There is still slight overextension here, so I'm going to read it. There's something slight, very slight here. Here still have more under cut removed. And I'm trying to remove the line angle here. There was a sharp line angle that went undetected in the first visit. On this side, still something here. And I'm going to round it out to make sure it's not fixed. In this case, when I begin doubting, I stop removing. لسه بقايا الوجع القديم لسه موجود. Okay? هاي حطيته. هلا مريح هيك صار؟ كيف صار الوضع؟
كويس.
خلص. طيب. Thank you.